So in previous videos, we've shown you how to take data and models that might be available online and also developed locally, combine those with some alternative what-if policy scenarios to generate forecasts of COVID-19 infections and deaths on your local computer. In this video, we're just going to show you briefly how you might be able to publish a subset of those forecasts online. So here's where we left off on the previous videos. We had generated a number of scenarios, in this case for Canada and its provinces, under different public health measure alternatives. And here we're showing the forecast for one of those jurisdictions, for Ontario. So now if we're interested in publishing these, we can use SynchroSim to push the results back online. We do it here using GitHub. And once those results are available online, then other applications can come along and serve them up. So if you go to our website, apexrms.com/COVID-19, you click on the model projections button, you'll come through to this prototype app that we developed for displaying these projections. So right now, this is actually displaying projections that were made a day later than the ones I've been showing you in the demo. But let's go back one day. Here are the projections that were made on May 16th, and we'll look at the one we were looking at in the previous videos. These are the projections made for deaths. We can also look at the projections for infections for Ontario using our SynchroSim modeling platform. So once these projections are available online, you know, there's a number of things we can do with them in addition to what we could do in the desktop. First of all, we've been pushing these projections every day for about 4 weeks now. So we can now go back in time. I'm going to go back 2 weeks ago and look at what the model projected 2 weeks ago for deaths and compare that, in this case for Ontario, to the actual deaths that have been recorded since the projection. So it gives us some indication of how well our model is doing. We can also compare the projections for one model to another. So in this case, we've drawn in some projections that are also available online for the US IHME model. And so I can turn those on as well, and we can see how the two models compare and how well each of the models are doing as compared to the actual recorded deaths over time.